Hello learners, welcome back to my channel Shraddha's Physics. Today we will discuss about the Gaussian wave packet. So let us start with the Gaussian wave packet. So in the previous lesson, we have already discussed about the plane wave and its representation, that is psi of xt. Suppose I am writing the wave function representing a wave packet. The wave function representing a wave packet is, it will be, we can write it as psi of xt equal to psi of xt. Psi is the representation of the wave packet. This is equal to, suppose, integration over minus infinite to infinite b of k exponential I kx exponential iota whole into kx minus omega t into dt. Okay, this is the plane wave representation, or we can say that this is the representation of the wave packet. If you can remember this expression in case of the Fourier transform, in case of Fourier transform, here 1 by root over 2 pi term comes on the right hand side, or simply we can say that we are representing the function in one domain and we want to convert this function into the other domain. Sorry, this is decay. Okay, this is decay. Since here you can see that this is the function of b of k, so here I am writing decay. The function in the x of x comma t means we want to express in the position as well as in the time coordinate. This is the psi of x t means this is the position and time coordinate. We will convert this k space into the position space. Slowly you will get a clear idea. So now this expression I can say that this expression will represent a Gaussian wave packet if this b of k is of the form, here I am writing this above equation. Suppose I am giving it equation 1. This equation, it represents the Gaussian wave packet if b of k, it is of the form b of k equal to b of k equal to exponential minus k naught whole square into alpha. Here this b of k, it is the Gaussian function in the k space. Okay, k space means this is the k is the wave vector, or you can say that this k is the propagation constant. So in the k space, when the value is peaked at the k naught point, in that case this b of k will represent the Gaussian function. Okay, and alpha here is some constant. So here I am representing this as the equation 2. Now if we will put equation 2 in equation 1, that is this b of k equal to exponential minus k naught whole square alpha, that is some square alpha, this will represent the Gaussian function. Exponential minus this minus k naught whole square means, suppose this is x square or t square or anything p square alpha. So this squaring function, exponential minus some square function, that is the Gaussian function. It will represent the Gaussian function. Now let me put this equation 2 in equation 1. So this will become psi of xt equal to, here I am writing psi of xt, this will be equal to integration over minus infinite to plus infinite, in place of b of k I am writing exponential minus k naught whole square into alpha, again this exponential iota kx minus omega t into decay. Now in this expression, if I'll consider, suppose at time t equal to 0, if I'll consider that at the initial condition, when the time equal to 0, in that condition, this wave function, this psi of x t, when t equal to 0, I can write it as psi of x. Since here in this exponential term, ikx minus omega t term, if I will put t equal to 0, then in that case, only exponential ikx term will remain. And in this particular integration on the right hand side, there will be no terms that will contain the t term. That's why I can convert this psi of x t as psi of x. So I can write it as psi of x equal to, since no term of t is present in this integration, I can write minus infinite to plus infinite exponential minus k minus k naught whole square into alpha into exponential ikx into decay. Here I have substituted t equal to 0, that's why minus I omega t term vanishes. Now let me write this equation on the next page. Psi of x equal to integration over minus infinite to plus infinite exponential minus k minus k naught whole square into alpha exponential ikx into decay. This much, up to this much we have calculated. Now let us substitute s as k minus k naught. Here I will substitute s equal to k minus k naught. Okay. So that ds will be equal to decay. Now let me substitute in this expression, then this will be equal to minus infinite to plus infinite exponential minus, in place of k minus k naught I am writing minus s square alpha into exponential iota, in place of k I am writing this as your k will be equal to s plus k naught, because if we will take this k naught on the left hand side, then this will be s plus k naught. So this will be s plus k naught. Since k naught is your constant, then it will not affect the integration into x, and again decay is my ds. Clear? Now I will take the constant term out to the integration. So this will becomes this I k naught x, I am writing here exponential iota k naught x. This term is constant, so taken outside, into integration minus infinite to plus infinite exponential, if I will take common minus alpha, then this will be the first term here, this first term, this will be s square, and in this term this will be I sx. So since I am taking common negative sign, so this will be negative of iota s into x, and since here we have taken common alpha, so this will be divided by alpha. Is that clear? This will be minus I s x divided by alpha into ds. Now let us see, in this exponential minus alpha s square minus I s x divided alpha term, let me modify this term. I am here taking only that term, that is s square, this term minus iota s into x divided by alpha. Here I am writing minus, suppose here I am writing x square divided by 4 alpha. Here I am adding and subtracting one term, this, that is x square divided by 4 alpha. If I will add and subtract this two term, then it will not affect the exact part, that is s square minus iss divided by alpha. Then this total term, this three term, it will represent, I can write it as s minus iota x divided by 2 alpha whole square plus x square divided by 4 alpha. Can I write like this? This will be 4 alpha square and this is alpha square. Okay, so that if you can see, this will be a minus b whole square form, that is a square minus 2ab. So minus 2 into 2, they will get cancelled. This is minus of iota s into x divided by alpha. So the second term is correct. And next, this will be ix by 2 alpha square. I square is minus 1 into x square divided by 4 alpha square. So this expression is correct now. Let me write this expression as s minus ix by 2 alpha as, suppose this is q and this is square, this is suppose q square, plus the second term remain as it is, that is x square divided by 4 alpha. Okay, if I substitute this term here, that will, I will substitute this term in this exponential term. Now this will be equal to exponential iota k naught x into integration over minus infinite to plus infinite exponential minus alpha whole into q square, plus this will be x square divided by 4 alpha, x square divided by 4 alpha whole into ds, or in place of ds I can write this is simply dq, because here we have considered q equal to this total term, that is s minus ix divided by 2 alpha. So the ds will be equal to dq. Again, this I just forgot to write alpha square, so let me correct. This is alpha square, so this will be s square divided by 4 alpha square. Now if I separate these two terms in the exponential, and if I see this exponential minus alpha q square into dq will remain inside the integration, and this second term I'll take out to the integration, so this will be equal to exponential iota k naught into x into exponential of, this will be minus alpha divided by alpha square, so this will be minus of x square divided by 4 alpha. Again, integration over minus infinite to plus infinite exponential minus alpha q square into dq. Is this correct? Exponential I k naught x into exponential minus s square divided by 4 alpha, integration over this exponential minus alpha q square into dq. Up to this much it is correct. This is the psi of x equal to this much. Okay, this is the expression for psi of x. Again, we know exponential of minus alpha q square dq, its value is exponential, here I am writing the value, this is equal to root over pi by alpha. This total integration value is exponential minus alpha q square dq is root over pi by alpha. If it is exponential minus q square dq, this is simply root over pi. If this is exponential minus alpha, some constant term, into q square dq, then its integration value will be root over pi by alpha. If I substitute this in this expression, then now this psi of x will be equal to exponential iota k naught x into exponential minus x square divided by 4 alpha into root over pi by alpha. Okay. Now in this expression, this exponential iota k naught x, what it will represent? This is simply the phase factor. This is the phase factor. This is the phase factor. And if it will multiply by root over pi by alpha, I can write it simply as f of x. Suppose this is f of x into exponential, here I am writing this exponential minus x square divided by 4 alpha. This is for psi of x. Psi of x equal to this much. For f of x equal to, here I am writing f of x equal to root over pi by alpha into exponential iota k naught x. This exponential I k naught x is the phase factor. Why I am considering that this is the phase factor? Because if I'll take the modulus of this exponential I k naught x modulus, then this will be equal to, you know, since this is in the complex form, if I'll take the modulus of it, then this will be iota k naught x into its conjugate, that is exponential minus iota k naught x. Then this will be exponential I k naught x minus I k naught x, this will goes to 0, that will be equal to exponential 0, which value is equal to 1. Okay, now if we'll take the f of x modulus square, then this will be equal to, here the value of f of x is root over pi by alpha into exponential I k naught x. So if I'll write this root over pi by alpha into exponential iota k naught x mod square, then this will be equal to, again this exponential, here I am writing exponential I k naught x modulus square is equal to 1, and this root over pi by alpha modulus square will be equal to pi by alpha. So its value will be pi by alpha. Now if I write psi of x modulus square, if I write the square modulus of this function, then this will be equal to, this is equal to, here you can see psi of x equal to f of x exponential minus x square divided by 4 alpha. So in place of psi of x, if I write this is f of x into exponential minus x square divided by 4 alpha, and this is the modulus square. Since this is the modulus square, f of x modulus square is pi by alpha here. So this will be pi by alpha into, again this exponential minus x square by 4 alpha modulus square will be equal to, let me write it here, exponential minus x square by 4 alpha into 2. So this will be modulus square will be into 2. So this will be 2, this 2, this will be get cancelled. Then this will be exponential minus x square divided by 2 alpha. So this will be exponential minus x square divided by 2 alpha. Okay. Because when you are taking the modulus of exponential minus x square by 4 alpha, simply you are writing exponential minus x square by 4 alpha into exponential minus x square by 4 alpha. Okay, so this term will get added. So this will be the twice of x square by 4 alpha minus x square by 4 alpha into 2. That's why this will be pi by alpha into exponential minus x square divided by 2 alpha. So this is for modulus of psi of x whole square. This is the square modulus of the wave function. This psi of x, it is nothing but the Gaussian wave function. Why? Because you can see that here this exponential minus x square term is present here. So this represents the Gaussian wave function. This is the Gaussian function of x. Gaussian function of x. Okay. Gaussian function of x. Now we will see the width of the Gaussian wave packet in the x space. X space means, x here represents the position space. X here means the position space. Okay. 1 is your x space and another 1 is your k space. Okay. This x space represents the position space. Here we have just calculated that the modulus of this function, that is psi of x modulus square, equal to pi by alpha exponential minus x square by 2 alpha. Here I am writing it again, psi of x modulus square, this is equal to pi by alpha into exponential minus x square divided by 2 alpha. Okay, so if I put at, suppose at x equal to 0 distance, at x equal to 0, it has the maximum value, or you can say that at x equal to 0, this modulus of psi x square, this will be equal to pi by alpha, which is the maximum value. This is the maximum value. Okay, its value gradually decreases. This exponential minus, it will depend on this exponential minus x square by 2 alpha, that is, it depends basically on the x term. So the modulus of this psi of x square, its value will drop. It will drop to 1 by e of its maximum value. Its maximum value is pi by alpha. When I can write, when this x square by 2 alpha equal to 1. When this x square by 2 alpha value will be equal to 1, then this will be dropped to 1 by e, we can say. You can see that when I will put x square by 2 alpha equal to 1, then this will be exponential minus 1. So this exponential minus 1 is nothing but 1 by e, or you can write this expression as, then x square will be equal to 2 alpha, x square equal to 2 alpha, or you can write it as x will be equal to plus or minus, this is root over of 2 alpha. This is the value of x, or we can calculate from this expression, we can calculate the width of the Gaussian wave packet. So the width of the Gaussian wave packet in the x space is, we can write it as, suppose delta x is the width of the Gaussian wave packet in the x space, then this will be equal to the difference between this plus or minus root over 2 alpha, that is plus root over 2 alpha minus of minus root over 2 alpha. So this will give the width of the packet, that will be equal to 2 alpha root over minus minus becomes plus root over 2 alpha, which is equal to twice of 2 alpha root over. This is the value of the delta x, or the width of the Gaussian packet, that is 2 into root over 2 alpha. Is this clear? Now we will calculate the width of the Gaussian wave packet in the k space. So let us calculate the width of the Gaussian wave packet in the k space. This k space, or we can say that this is the momentum space. Since you know p equal to linear momentum equal to h cot k, so this k basically represents the wave vector, or this is known as the propagation constant, but we can represent this momentum as h cot k. So k space basically represent the momentum space. This can be called as the momentum space. Okay. Now just calculate the width of the Gaussian packet in the k space. We know this B of k, the Gaussian wave packet, this B of k in this Gaussian packet equal to exponential minus k naught whole square into alpha. This equation is 2, equation number 2. So if I take the modulus, square modulus of this B of k, then our expression will be, let me write B of k first. This B of k equal to exponential minus k minus k naught whole square into alpha. Okay. So the modulus, square modulus of this expression, B of k modulus square, this will be equal to, here I have to just multiply this term again, exponential minus k naught whole square alpha into exponential minus k naught whole square into alpha. So this is simply twice of this much, that is equal to exponential minus 2 into k minus k naught whole square into alpha. This is the square modulus of bk. Here if I put k equal to k naught, when it will rise to the peak value means it will reach to the k naught point, in that condition this exponential term, it will goes to, in place of k, if I put k naught, then this will be exponential 0, which is equal to 1. So we can say that this B of k modulo square have the maximum value, that is 1, when it is peaked at the value k equal to k naught. And again, its value will drop to 1 by e, its value again drop to 1 by e, if I will put this 2 alpha into k minus k naught whole square, k naught whole square, this is equal to 1. You can see that if I will put in this expression, here I am giving some expression, suppose x. In this expression, if I will put this 2 alpha into k minus k naught whole square equal to 1, then its value goes to 1 by e. So from this expression, we can calculate this will be equal to, this implies k minus k naught whole square, this is equal to 1 by 2 alpha, and again this k minus k naught, this will be equal to plus or minus root over of 1 by 2 alpha, okay? Or you can write this k equal to k naught plus or minus root over of 1 by 2 alpha. So this k equal to k naught plus or minus, plus or minus 1 by 2 alpha root over, okay? So the width of the Gaussian wave packet in the k space is, since our value of k equal to, we have calculated k equal to k naught plus or minus root over of 1 by 2 alpha. So to calculate the width, so this will be delta k, that is equal to, once I will take the for the plus sign and then for the negative sign, and we have to take the difference between that. So this will be k naught plus the root over of 1 by 2 alpha minus k naught minus the root over of 1 by 2 alpha. Okay. I have just taken the difference between these two k values. If I'll open this bracket, then this will k naught will get cancelled with this minus k naught, and this again will be 1 by 2 alpha root over minus of minus, this will becomes plus 1 by 2 alpha root over, this will be 2 into 1 by 2 alpha root over, okay? And again, if we'll cancel this term, I will get 2 by alpha, I will get 2 by alpha root over. But let me take this relation, that is delta k will be equal to 2 into 1 by 2 alpha root over. So what we get, delta k is finally equal to 2 into 1 by 2 alpha root over. This is our final expression for the width of the wave packet in the Gaussian wave packet in the wave space, k space, okay? And the width of the Gaussian wave packet in the x space, we have calculated delta x equal to how much? 2 into 2 alpha root over, okay? Now, if I multiply this delta x with the delta k, then delta x into delta k will be equal to 2 into 2 alpha root over into 2 into 1 by 2 alpha root over, okay? Which is equal to, if this 2 alpha root over get cancelled, then this will be equal to 4. So, we get delta x into delta k, that is equal to 4. Now we know p equal to h cot k, p equal to h cot k. We can write delta p equal to h cot into delta k, where p is the momentum, linear momentum, and k is the wave vector. So in this delta k, we can write here delta k, we can write this will be equal to delta k equal to delta p divided by h cut. So if I'll put this here, this will be delta x into delta p divided by h cut, this will be equal to 4. Or we can write simply it as delta p, this is basically we are calculating in the x space, that's why I'm representing this as in the x plane. So this is delta x into delta px, the substitute x denotes the linear momentum in the x space, that is equal to 4 into h cut. What is this h cut? Simply you have to write h and give a bar in this h line. So this is nothing but h bar equal to h by 2 pi. This h bar is nothing but h by 2 pi. H is the Planck's constant. Now we can write this delta x into delta px, that is this will be greater than equal to h. Okay, this the final expression will be delta x into delta px will be greater than h. So if I decrease this delta px, it means that if I decrease this delta px, that is the width of the Gaussian wave packet in the momentum space. So the wave function in the k space, it most aptly peaked at the k equal to k naught point. Then at that condition, delta x will increase. So this basically represents that the wave function psi of x, this wave function, it increasingly delocalized. It getting delocalized. Similarly, if we increase the delta k, if we increase this delta k, this the width of the Gaussian packet, so the wave function, this b of k, is delocalized in the k space. Now we can say that this psi of x, it will become more strongly localized about x equal to 0. So what I mean to say is that we cannot make both delta x and this delta px or delta k, this delta k and delta x small simultaneously. Simultaneously, we cannot make this delta x and delta k value, we cannot make this value very small simultaneously. Okay, simultaneously this value cannot be made small. So this is all about your Gaussian wave packet and the width of the Gaussian wave packet in the position space as well as in the k space. This is all for today. If you have any doubt, can ask me in the comment section. If you like the video, can give a like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Jai Jagannath.